So, you're probably asking yourself, out of all the amazing and quality films out there, why on earth did you choose The Lone Ranger? And that's a valid question. The film had heaps of production issues, including being canceled and then revived. It also bombed terribly at the box office, causing Disney to lose hundreds of millions of dollars. And it was surrounded by controversy, not just because of its violent content, which was a bit out of place for a Disney film, also because Johnny Depp was playing a race completely different than his own. But at the end of the day, when you revisit this film, you might find something rather special. It's a pure popcorn tentpole western, one of which we will never again see in film history. Everything about this film was done as a love letter to the genre, and done with the best intentions. If you look at it closely, you'll see it pays homage to the past. The fact that this movie was even made, though, is a bit of a miracle, and even though it fell flat on its face, I may be one of the few people who absolutely loved it and appreciate all the minute details that were thrown into it. Verbinski and Jerry Bruckheimer wrangled the Pirates of the Caribbean team back together for this effort, and it echoes the same tone and feel of those films. This is just a big-budget western meant to entertain. It has dazzling set pieces, all shot on location, this great grand setting, a bold score, fantastic costumes, and this lush production design. It also has one of the best action scenes possibly in the history of action filmmaking, and I'm going to go ahead and say that, because no matter what you think of this film as a whole, that train finale is one of the most impressive set pieces to ever be shot and put together. So, for this scene study, we'll be looking at the entire train finale. But instead of watching the scene first without interruption, we're just gonna dive right in due to how long this scene is. And since there is so much going on, along with the sound effects, the editing, the music, that all of that you're gonna need to be paying attention to, I'm gonna switch from voiceover commentary to text commentary. So just keep an eye out at the bottom of the screen as we dive into this amazing set piece. Also, one thing to note about the score for this scene, while Hans Zimmer composed the music for the film, it was actually Geoff Zanelli who was tasked at adapting and arranging the William Tell Overture and weaving in Hans's themes. This entire sequence was a mammoth undertaking, and it actually took Geoff a couple months to score it. Also, to appreciate the score in this scene as a bonus, I'm gonna tack on the scene at the end of this scene study with an isolated score track, so you can actually really examine how much heavy lifting the music really does. So without further ado, let's go.
Yeah! tends to land on her feet.
John!
What you gonna do, counselor? Shoot me?
That's right.
Guess I cut out the wrong brother's heart. Don't tell me. You boxed in law school. Matter of fact, I did.
Train's headed. The future. Well, this here train, she going straight to hell.
You know something, Butch? I believe you're right.
Enjoy the ride!
Up, Indian.
Pretty soon, no one will even know you people were here.
I'm a spirit walker. I can't miss.
Just another white man. Who are you? Bad tree.
You let him get away?
bad trade.